Hello students, let us solve some examples based on angle bisector property. The first question is based on this diagram given. In the diagram, triangle MNP is given where NQ is the angle bisector of angle N. If MN is 5, PN is 7, MQ is 2.5, then find QP. So here in this problem, we have to find the length of segment QP. Now, as this is a triangle given, we have the angle bisector property, and the property is if there is a triangle given and there is angle bisector of one of the angles of a triangle, then that angle divides side opposite to them in the proportion of remaining two sides. So here the angle bisector of angle N is given, so side opposite to angle N is MP. So this ray divide this side in the proportion of remaining two sides. So the remaining two sides of this triangle are MN and MP. So if we take the ratio of MN and NP, it must be equal to the ratio of MQ and QP. So here in triangle MNP, as NQ is the angle bisector of angle MNP, so by the angle bisector property, we have MN divided by NP, it is equal to MQ divided by PQ. One thing we should note here that we have taken the ratio MN divided by PN. So it must be equal to MQ divided by PQ. We cannot take PQ divided by MQ because that will not be the same proportion as MN divided by PN. So if we take MN in the numerator for the first ratio, in the second ratio, we should take MQ in the numerator. So we have this ratio MN by NP is equal to MQ by QP. Now we have the three values out of four. The length of MN is 5. So we should replace here MN by 5. NP is 7. MQ is 2.5 divided by QP that we have to find. So if we take QP to the left hand side, it will be in the numerator. It is QP is equal to 2.5 on the right hand side as it is. If we take 5 by 7 to the right hand side, it will be its reciprocal, that is 7 by 5. Now if we simplify this, if we divide 5 by 2.5, it should be QP is equal to 7 divided by 2, because 2.5 into 2, that's 5. Now if we divide 7 by 2, we get 3.5. So the length of segment QP is 3.5. Let us have another problem. The question is based again on this diagram given. In this diagram, we have to find QP using the given information. So as we can observe, triangle MNP is given over here. As angle MNQ and angle PNQ are shown by the same symbol, that means segment PQ is the angle bisector of angle MNP. So that is given, and the three lengths of sides are given. So as there is angle bisector is given, we should use the angle bisector property. Before that, we have triangle MNP where NQ bisects angle MNP, that is ray NQ bisects angle MNP. So if it is the case, we can apply angle bisector property. So here the angle is MNP, so side opposite to it is MP. So this angle bisector divides side MP in the proportion of remaining two sides, and the remaining two sides are MN and NP. So by angle bisector property, we can write MN divided by NP is equal to MQ divided by QP. So length of MN is given to be 25, length of NP is 40 is equal to length of segment MQ is 14 divided by QP, because we have to find QP. Again, if we take QP on the left hand side, we get QP is equal to 14 on the right hand side as it is. If we transfer 25 by 40 to the right hand side, it will be 40 divided by 25. Now if we divide here by 5, we get 5 is a 25 and 5 8 is a 40. So we'll get QP is equal to 14 into 8 by 5. If we multiply the numerators, 14 into 8, that's 112 divided by 5. Now if we divide 112 by 5, we get QP is equal to 22.4. So this is the length of segment QP. QP is equal to 22.4 units. Let us have another problem. Again, it is based on this diagram. The question is, in triangle LMN, ray MT bisects angle LMN. Here LM is given to be 6, MN is given to be 10, and TN is 8. From that we have to find LT. So here also for a triangle, ray MT is given to be angle bisector. So in triangle LMN, ray MT bisects angle LMN, that's given. So again here we have to use the angle bisector property, and by that we have two sides of angles LM and MN. That means if we take the ratio of LM and MN, that would be equal to LT divided by TN. We have LM by MN is equal to LT divided by TN. We have the length of LM, that's 6, divided by length of MN is 10. That is equal to LT we have to find, so we'll keep that as it is, divided by TN is 8. Now if we transfer 8 to the left hand side, we get LT is equal to 8 into 6 by 10. Now if we simplify, we divide here by 2, we get 2 4s are 8 and 2 5s are 10. That is 4 into 6 by 5. Now we'll multiply numerator, 6 into 4, that's 24, divided by 5. If we divide 24 by 5, we get LT is equal to 4.8. So this is the length of segment LT. So this is how we can solve some examples by using the angle bisector property. I hope you understand this concept. Thanks for watching.